Matt Bukowiak joins us now with some analysis on how things are looking.
That's right. Matt is the chairman of the Travis County Republican Party. And Matt, thank you so much for being with us tonight. I know things are busy for you.
Good to see you.
Well, Texas has been reliably a red state for quite a while now, but some analysts are calling Texas a toss-up state. In your opinion, is there any chance that Democrats will win the presidency or the U.S. Senate race?
No, I think Trump's going to win Texas. We analyzed the vote through early voting, and he's up. He was up about 100,000 raw votes, and he's going to win decisively across the state on Election Day. So I expect him to be in the 4%, 5%, maybe 6% range in terms of the statewide margin. John Cornyn is going to overperform the president by a few points, so he's going to win by 7% to 9%. The action is down ballot in the congressional races, in the state house races, in one of the state senate races. That's what's going to be most competitive.
Which races do you see, Matt, to be the most competitive right now as you look down the ballot at some of those congressional races?
Yeah, there's 8 or 9 of them, honestly, that both sides are hotly contesting. I mean, I would put Congressional District 21, which is, of course, part of Travis County with Chip Roy and Wendy Davis. That is going to be a barn burner. It's about 1% right now separating them. It's going to be very, very, very close. I'm involved in the Texas 23, this Congressional District 23 race between Tony Gonzalez and Gene Ortiz Jones. I believe Tony will win, but it's going to be close as well. There are others in Houston and Dallas, that are going to be very competitive. So we'll see whether the Democrats can pick up a few congressional seats tonight.
All right, Matt, let's talk a little bit about Austin's city council races. Half of the council seats up for election tonight. This could sort of be, I guess, a referendum on issues like homelessness and policing here in Austin.
Yeah, we've looked at the early vote so far, and it appears that 2 of the 3 competitive races are going to go to runoffs, which is a very good outcome. District 6 and District 10. District 6 with Jimmy Flanagan, the incumbent, and the challenger, Mackenzie Kelly, are pretty close, actually. I think it's 38-35 right now. District 10 is also very close. You're going to see Allison Alter, the incumbent, get pulled into a runoff by Jennifer Verdin, first-time candidate. We've got 25%. I think Alter's around 35 or maybe 38%. So you're going to have 2 December runoffs. And I think those issues are going to be front and center. If people are tired of the police budget cut, if they're tired of the homelessness crisis that we're seeing everywhere across our city, they have an opportunity to elect two outstanding pro-taxpayer candidates in the runoffs.
All right, Matt Bukowiak, thank you so much for your time. It's always a pleasure to visit with you, especially on a busy night like tonight. Enjoy the rest of the evening.
Take care.